I strongly recommend you watch the whole video because I have a lot of great information you'll need to know. But first, make sure you subscribe if you're brand new. Let's do this. Yo, what's going on, Hero Clash? Welcome back to a brand new video, part 13, Arena! Let's go, as you can see on the screen. Wait. Arena, we have four categories. We have the Crucible, my all-time favorite. We have Legendary Duel, my second all-time favorite. We have Daily Arena, and then we have Glorious Arena, which is my third favorite, also being my all-time favorite when it comes to testing out heroes, okay? So with that being said, let's jump straight into the video.
Hey honk.
First things first, we have Glorious Arena. Pay attention. What you see and what I see is completely different. Yeah, you can battle for first place and keep it like that, but I'm going to give you guys a secret tip that I use when it comes to my competition, okay? First things first, this category unlocks every Saturday and Sunday, approximately, and if you go down to team, you get to create three teams. Now here's some huge, top secret, professional gaming advice. When you are in here, you're usually in like 10th place, 15th place, 20th place. If you're close to someone on your server who is similar in skill, similar in, you know, power, here's what you do. Go to that person and look at their team, right? Now let's say they have their first team stacked, right? They have their first team stacked. And let's say they use that team in the Crucible as well. Okay. What you want to do is on that first team, figure out a strategy and how to beat that first team. However, your second and third team, I want you to put the worst heroes in, right? Now the question is why? Why would you do that? The reason why is you get unlimited chances to go against their best team while they still win the last two rounds, which means you won't take that first place, second place, third place from them, which means you can battle them unlimited amount of times to figure out how you can beat their personal team. Huh?
I can't tell you how many times people stack their very first team with the exact same team they used from the Crucible. Never, ever, ever, ever do this because someone like me is gonna come across and wipe you out with ease too. It's very, very easy to analyze an enemy account and see how strong they are. What are their weaknesses? What are they going to do? And like I said, we're, as humans, we live by patterns. So if you identify a pattern, you can take advantage of it.
So long story short, that's what I did when the Guardian Ruins came out. There was this guy named Hunkleberry. He put the Guardian Ruins on Natalie. And I went against them, and my team just was shredded, man, hands down. Like, both of our teams made it to round three. His Natalie went first, and my team just got wiped out. I was like, wow, interesting. So then that's when I created the strategy, and I figured out a method to where I could beat his Natalie in the Crucible, and that's what happened, right? So at the last second on Sunday, I took first place from him, making him have second place in Glorious Arena. And then I went to the Crucible that week, and beat him in the Crucible for first place.
If I did not use this strategy, I would have lost the Crucible 100%. When I started using this strategy, I was able to get my win ratio, Natalie versus Natalie, up to about 91%, which I'm extremely comfortable with when it comes to the Crucible.
So you have to be smart when it comes to this knowledge, okay? So next things next, we're gonna move on to Daily Arena, which is my least favorite. Once you get past 3100, which is the king right here, then it's absolutely pointless. It just comes down to if people in your server want to be in first place or second place. I like having first place. I love it being in sync, you know, Trinity GX, Trinity GX, Trinity GX, Trinity GX. You know, that's what I like. So, you know, it is what it is. That's why I always say stack your daily arena coupons, your tickets from, you know, the daily merchant or whatever, giant merchant, and just pile them up, right? Really quick tip for daily arena. For those who are free to play or those who barely spend money into the game, then I recommend you always have this refresh button. If you want to get higher a little bit faster, just refresh every 15 minutes for free and then play out the first three games at the bottom. Usually on average, you'll win the bottom three games, okay? So then, yeah, you'll get 6-7 points here and there, but guess what? you're going up and in 15 minutes refresh for free and go from there, okay? Moving on to Legendary Duel. Now this one, it's all about timing, right? So usually you'll have some gung-ho type players in your arena on your server for Legendary Duel. And currently there are, where's it at? Oops, register there. 1, 2, 3. There are 5 levels. And depending on where you're at in the game, you're going to play all 5. That simple. However, if you're brand new, start off with Silver Group and just learn how it works. Right now, I'm going to give a pro tip in a beginner's guide. So here we go. Okay. So first things first, no matter where you're at, always analyze the top 3, top 4 people. So what you have to do is go over to challenge and then click, let's say him. Looking at his team, he's clearly not playing, so I would clearly just win that battle. However, what I'm saying is analyze their team and organize it in a way for you to win. That's pretty much all I'm saying. And when it comes to the end, there are 2 strategies when the countdown has like 5 minutes left. For first place, you either want to be hundreds and hundreds of points ahead of your competition, or you want to be close to your competition for first place. And then when it comes to challenge, you want to make sure there's 1 person left in the challenge, right? It doesn't have to be them. So when that last 30 seconds roll by, right, you quickly spam this game. Boom, spam, boom, too easy. And then it's going to refresh and they should be on top, okay? And then the person, even if they do beat you with 5 seconds left, all you gotta do is like, oh no, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, boom, first place, let's go, woo! Okay? And then a super pro tip, right? During those last 1 to 2 minutes, if you do have a gung-ho enemy who's like, you know what, I'm gonna beat this person in the last second, secretly what you wanna do is when it comes to your defense, you're gonna wanna secretly rotate your 3rd, 4th, and 5th team around so they don't see it coming, hands down.
Yes, you're gonna wanna rotate your team. However, before you do rotate your teams, make sure you identify the weakest link when it comes to that enemy beating you before those 2 minutes are up. So let's say they used Alvarez on team number 3, they used Dragonic on team number 4, and they used Phoenix on team number 5. I'm gonna identify their weakest enemy and then put my strongest team out of the team 3, team 4, team 5 to face their weakest. So that's how I increase the chances of this trick winning.
I do this all the time and it works 100% of the time. They just might get lucky and not work, but it hasn't failed me yet, right? And as the weeks and months go on, my competition has been giving up, so I'm cool with that, right? So next thing with Legendary, you have a Legend Store. I talked about this in a previous video on Giant Merchant. Check it out if you want me to go into depth about the Giant Merchant Legend Store, okay? Moving on to the Crucibles. Yes, one of my all-time favorites. We are one of the best in the EA when it comes to Crucible, right? Now, what is my strategy? Why do I always win, right? Okay, so first things first, for you to get to the Crucible, I'll be honest, in the top 8, you're probably gonna have to spend some money. It's pay to win. Sorry, that's just the reality of it. If you're free to play, my free to play account is almost 200 days in approximately, and my account made it to the Crucible, like the top 64, right? Let's see if I can find it actually. It's in the elimination round. Actually, it'll take too long to figure out. Anyways, but yeah, so Crucible are for those who are play to win and who want to win. That's just the reality of it. So advice to everyone in the Crucible in the top 8, top 16, what I recommend is, it says, oh, make your first team the strongest. No. That is terrible advice. That message is nonsense. What you want to do is you want your third team to be the best. You want your third team to be the strongest. Then you want your second team to be the bait team. And then you want your first team to be the bait team.
What I mean by bait team is if you look at the enemy in the Crucible, and let's say they put all their resources, all their money in just the Phoenix, well, I can have that first team waste Phoenix's first ability and waste her energy to win that first round, which she's just gonna wipe out my bait team, and she's gonna start the second game going against my actual team, and she won't be able to attack that first round. She won't be able to use her special ability. She's gonna be wiped out, man, hands down. Dude, I love doing this so much. So always identify the enemies you're going against and use the bait technique, hands down. Trinity Jex, approved, baby.
So I created this strategy when it comes to people having multiple S+ heroes unlocked, like, you know, Natalie, when they're all on separate teams. And you don't want to stack all your S plus heroes on one team, because if I do this strategy, you will lose every single time, okay? So what I recommend is analyze your enemy, know what he's going to do from previous games. People, humans are made up of patterns. Everyone has patterns, and when it comes to the Crucible, you will see those patterns in your enemy's strategy, right? So go back, look at the previous games, see what they're doing, and then organize from there, right? So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video about Arena. We dropped so much information, and I'll see y'all in the next video, part 14, Greatness Manifested.